On one level, we can't stop environmental disaster. We live on a very dynamic planet, and Mother Nature will do what she wants. I would argue, at our peril, do we try to stop things like hurricanes, because they play an integral role in making the overall ecology and environment of the planet function. I think we'd be, it would be hubris in the greatest sense of the classic Greek word to imagine that we should just reach in and turn the Nile if we found a phenomenon inconvenient to our way of life today. The question in that domain is, what ways can we make our communities, our economies, more resilient, that better able to withstand those sorts of phenomena when they happen.
So technology in the hands of virtually everyone really gives us a chance to mitigate environmental disasters. In Bangladesh, there's a system that's set up where if there's a cyclone coming, people get text messages that have a plus sign. And the more plus signs, the more they know they need to keep their boats close to shore. And just this little simple technology saving thousands of lives in the Bay of Bengal. The other piece is nature. So nature-based solutions, I think, are the most resilient solutions to mitigating environmental disaster. When you build a dike or a wall or a dam or anything like that, when you bolster up a shoreline with riprap and sand and concrete, every year from that point onwards, your maintenance cost goes up and that structure weakens. Nature-based solutions work in the exact opposite way. Once you put them in place, the longer they are, the stronger they become.
I would say the best tool on some level is getting kids in the outdoors again, making them get interested in what a bug is and a grasshopper.
Look at the Earth from space. You know, that picture that we see all the time, the NASA picture, the blue marble. That's an incredible picture. You know, there's nothing in our DNA that says that as a species, we can get off the planet and have a look at the entire planet. That's awesome. Took an incredible amount of technology to do that. But we look at it and where do we go? Meh. It's just no big deal. You know, we take it for granted. And I think that sets a tone for people that despite faster internet, despite all these better tools, the most important thing hasn't sunk in is that this is about us.
Yeah, you got around to small questions, aren't you?